process isn't only just about manipulating material, it's also about manipulating your thought patterns and your mind and your, you know, it's bigger than that. It's a term that's used by art historians, which I think is really distorted from reality, because I think people like Vermeer or Jackson Pollock, I mean, the range of people who are involved in process, this is what we do. And I mean, there's this film that everybody thinks is terrific showing Jackson Pollock painting a painting, and it's shot underneath a piece of glass, and he's going around putting his paint on top of this piece of glass. Well, that's bullshit. It's not how Jackson Pollock paints a painting, because Jackson Pollock doesn't paint a painting with lights and a cameraman and people watching him and have him apply paint on top of a piece of glass. And it's what we do. It's what we, you know, with me, I manipulate materials. You know, I think about things. I have ideas. My ideas change. My materials change. I mean, it's hopefully it's like a verb in the sense that it's moving. It's going on. It's moving. Sometimes it doesn't even finish within one piece. Sometimes it takes 10 pieces to finish the piece. If I have an idea or a concept that I want to put into a piece of sculpture, and I start working, and in the process of working, something else occurs that really interests me, I'll abandon that idea in a second. You know, I'm not a process artist. That's a bogus, to me, that's a bogus category. I've gone through a lot of different materials. This clear casting resin is the main material. And that's sort of where I started, not as an artist, but as a young guy in California, you know, at 16, where, you know, I'm so old, you couldn't buy a surfboard. No, they didn't sell them yet. They didn't manufacture them yet. So we used to make our own, you know, which was basically a balsa wood core. Then we would fiberglass it afterward. And I didn't think about art at all in doing that. I just knew the material from that experience. And then when I went to San Francisco State, where California had all this money for their education, we had gallons of the stuff that we could use. So I would play with it. I really enjoyed it because it gave me possibilities that other materials did not. Translucency, transparency, manipulating light. Went to the Y to do some running, and I'd been working in the studio all day getting ready for this show at Paula Cooper's. And I started smelling resin, and I realized the resin was coming out of my skin. I was smelling it out of my skin. So I ran down and saw a toxicologist. He told me to run for 2 years, 5 miles a day, and drink a lot of milk. And I did. I hated it. I liked the milk, but I hated the running.